prove that the tangent at any point of the circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. Here we need to prove that it is a kind of a theorem. So what it is telling us to us that we have a circle and we have a point, our line perpendicular to this circle. So from any point we need to prove that the circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. So if this is the point of contact, then the circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. We need to prove that the tangents of these circles, the tangent of these circles is perpendicular is to the radius or through the point of contact. Let's try to prove that. First of all, we have this circle and we have this line, and this is the radius and this is a tangent to the circle. We need to prove that it is perpendicular to the circle. So here we can say that a circle C, this is the circle we are talking about, with coordinates O and R. These are the coordinates O and a tangent perpendicular at point A. This point we are talking about, OA. This R is the radius. This is also becomes a radius. So we need to prove that OA is perpendicular to L, this line. So we need to do some constructions for this. We will take a point B and another point A on the tangent I. On this tangent we will take a point D and join OB. Suppose OB meets in the circle C, and we will join OB so that OC meets circle C. We know that among all the line segments joining the point O to the point I, the perpendicular is shortest to the length. So this is the circle. The perpendicular will be shortest distance to this line. So from that we can say that OA equal to OC, the radius of the circle. This is the point O, this is the point tangent, this is the point C we have just drawn or considered. So we are saying that both are the radius of the circle, so both should be equal. Now we are saying that OB, which will the point be another drew on the circle, OB that is equal to OC plus BC. This is the point B and this is the point C, the distance from here to here. So that we are saying it is equal. Since OB is greater than OC and OB is greater than OA and OA is greater than OB, B is an arbitrary point on this tangent and O is the shorter than any line segment to any point on this I. So from that we can say that OA is perpendicular to I.